Imagine your family member in the hospital in need of life-saving medication after a heart attack. Now, can you imagine that that same drug can be found in mosquitoes? Could such a pesky bug be of use as lupus treatment? It turns out that the saliva of blood-sucking female mosquitoes carries similar anti-clotting factors to that of our own blood. Heparin is primarily found in female mosquitoes, as they are the only hematophagous, or blood-feeding, mosquitoes. They use heparin in their saliva to avoid blood clots during feeding. Blood clotting, also known as thrombosis, can cut off circulation in parts of the body, leading to pulmonary embolisms, strokes, and heart attacks. However, people who have lupus, a chronic autoimmune disease, lack the necessary anti-clotting factors and therefore have a higher risk of blood clotting and must take medications, such as heparin. Using cutting-edge pharmaceutical research, the medical efficiency of heparin found in mosquito saliva will be compared against that of commercial heparin. Heparin is an anticoagulant, or blood thinner, used for heart surgery, dialysis, and in treating thrombosis for immediate action. It brings relatively fast results, making it more favorable than warfarin in medical situations requiring immediate action. Heparin and warfarin are often taken by people suffering from lupus, as they are more prone to thrombosis. Since the more popular drug, warfarin, cannot be used during pregnancy, heparin is necessary for pregnant women who require blood thinners. Although efforts have been made to produce it synthetically, heparin is naturally found in the mucus of cattle and swine intestines, and more recently has been found in mosquito saliva. Right now, China is the largest producer of heparin worldwide, but pig intestine is the only universally approved mucus. I am an aspiring doctor of pharmacy studying at Johns Hopkins University. I'll work in collaboration with the Dutch pharmaceutical company HePAC and the FDA to help diversify the heparin industry and increase its availability to all. Our research will be conducted at Johns Hopkins Lupus Center alongside Dr. Michelle Petrie, who has worked closely researching the mortality of lupus victims who deal with thrombosis and blood clots every day. My work will continue the works of researchers at the Pohang University of Science and Technology in Korea on the quantity of heparin production in female mosquitoes. I plan to use this data to additionally test the medicinal qualities of heparin produced in comparison to other anticoagulant drugs on the market. Since synthetic heparin is still not fully understood and has proven to be problematic in the past, it will not be tested with in our experiment. For the purpose of our testing, we will consider swine and bovine heparin as the commercial heparin. In order to conduct research, many female mosquitoes will be needed, as well as a mosquito rearing chamber to contain them, and pipettes and sugar water to maintain the population. Due to the short lifespan of mosquitoes, the incubation period would be only a few weeks. Once the female mosquitoes have aged to maturity, they will produce heparin that can be extracted for use. After anesthetizing the mosquitoes by freezing them in petri dishes, the mosquitoes will be transferred to a PBS solution, where the salivary gland will be taken out using tweezers. The heparin will then be extracted using a heparin ELISA kit and stored in test tubes for later. The heparin will be refined by removing blood and other contaminants from the sample using filters, tweezers, waters, and by other means necessary. After 1 to 2 months of extraction and refinement, the drug could go into the testing phase. The testing phase would start with rats and other small mammals, with intent to eventually move on to humans. The test subjects would be equally chosen to receive mosquito heparin, swine heparin, and bovine heparin, and the efficiencies of each would be recorded. The resulting data could conclude which drug is most effective and potentially uncover a new way of treating blood clotting. If the mosquito heparin does indeed prove effective or more effective than commercial counterparts, then steps could be taken to commercialize it through the FDA. One major stigma that would have to be outweighed is the idea that mosquitoes are useless other than being vectors for disease. While it is true that mosquitoes can carry diseases such as malaria and that some of this transition may be associated with heparin, it is important that the drug be disassociated from these ideas. By maintaining an isolated population where no insect is exposed to malaria strains or other disease strains, and by properly disposing of mosquitoes after extraction, we can ensure that the drug will not have any unwanted side effects. The heparin industry is a fairly large one. Over 200 tons of heparin are consumed annually. 10 to 12 million Americans are treated with heparin each year, and over 80% of the heparin comes from pigs. With such a large industry, there must be a supply to match. However, the swine industry has seen a definite decline over the years, leading to a global heparin shortage. This shortage is due in part to a disease that has affected swine populations called the blue ear disease in pigs. This disease affects the lungs, making it unable to take the mucus from the lungs and make heparin from it. It also stays within a population, making it hard to bounce back from such an endemic. A global heparin shortage could have dramatic effects on both the pharmaceutical industry and the medical industry as a whole. Without heparin, hospitals like Boston Children's Hospital are facing major challenges in treating patients with lupus. Without the necessary medications, hospitals put patients in critical care at risk of loss of life. In knowing that diversity strengthens a population, we can realize that the heparin industry is no different. By diversifying the market, we can help stabilize the global heparin industry and help hospitals everywhere treat lupus. As China begins to gain a monopoly on the heparin market, many researchers have begun to search for alternative mediums in which to extract the drug. By testing the efficiency of mosquito heparin in comparison to swine and bovine heparin, a potentially cheaper and more effective anticoagulant drug can be placed on the market and potentially alleviate the carbon footprint of the industry, as mosquitoes are much smaller and produce much less gas. An effective mosquito heparin could change the pharmaceutical market and overall impact the lives of the people affected by blood clotting, including lupus victims.